The conflict in the Middle East is a complicated one. It goes back decades. In fact, it goes back centuries. Or if you want to go through history, you can even go back thousands of years. It is a chronic, difficult, painful, tragic, enormously difficult to resolve problem. But what happened on October the 7th? And I know I've had this debate with the leader before. We had to condemn that specific episode on October the 7th when Hamas launched an attack on civilians and took hostages. This was a blatant and abhorrent act of terrorism, which cannot be justified by any circumstance, context, historical reason or justification. Now, why are we so obsessed with calling out terrorism wherever we see it? And we tell the world, no excuses, no pretexts, no justification. Why? The reason we take this stand again is not because we are taking sides or that we're trying to correct history or rewrite history. We can't. We're talking about conflict for thousands of years. We're only a country of 59 years of independence. No, we're not. We have taken that categorical stand because terrorism is a clear and present threat to Singapore. To excuse terrorism now, for whatever reason, in fact, puts Singapore at risk. Let me share with you, every time I read about rockets being fired or an insurgent force killing, raping, maiming civilians or taking hostages, actually the truth is on October the 7th, my thoughts were not so much in Gaza. I was thinking, if rockets landed in Bukit Panjang, if an insurgent force entered Woodlands, if 1,200 Singaporeans were killed, if 200 Singaporeans were kidnapped, that's what I was thinking of. So when I say foreign policy begins at home, I tell you, your foreign minister spends more time thinking about what if that happens here. What would we need to say? What would we need to do? What would be the job of my diplomats, and especially my permanent representative in New York? And if we had to face the Security Council. So I hope you understand why we have to be so categorical at times like this, even though we know it is an emotionally fraught moment.